only Lord who can know all the Vedas. Therefore, he says that Bhagavan here refers to Lord and not to Brahma, because only he has this ability to study all these Vedas. Kalavyapi sa kutastha ek ruptayaya. Therefore, he is called kutastha because he is all pervading. Ateva uktam svayameva. Therefore, Krishna also says this in the 11th canto while speaking to Uddhava. There he says that kim vidhatte kim achaste kim anudya vikalpayet yityasya hridaye loke nanyo madveda kashyam. He says, what does the Vedas prescribe? What do they prohibit? What do they repeat? What are the different options given there? What is the real essence? He says, except for me, no one else knows it. It is not possible for a common person to know. So he has to reveal it to us. Otherwise nobody can know. Satat vastu adhyavasyat sarva veda pratipadyatvena nischakaya. So he studied and then he came to only one conclusion. And the conclusion was yataya atmani swasmin vati prema bhavet. So that is the best process which leads to love towards the Lord. So he created Vedas and he breathed out the Vedas. And this has to have meaning for him, not for somebody else. So Rati Premno here, Prathma Avastha Rati. Rati, the word which has been used here, is the first stage of love. Love also has different levels, different stages. So Rati is the beginning stage. It's also called Bhav. So this is what Sukhdev has also recommended, and this is what Lord himself recommends. This is what is the recommendation of the Vedas. Now he says that this thing is not only for one person or two person. It is for everybody. Therefore he says, Bhagavan sarva bhuteshu lakshitaya swatmana harihi drishyair buddhyadibhir drashta lakshmair anumapate. Says that actually speaking, there is nothing else which exists here in this world. He is existing in everything, sarva bhuteshu. And who is he? He is Bhagavan Hari, Lord Krishna. So Krishna exists in everything and everything is indicating him. Whatever you see around you, if you study it properly, then it only points towards the Lord. It's only out of ignorance that we don't realize this fact. But everything is moving or indicating towards the Lord. Drishyair buddhyadibhir drashta lakshanair anumakate. Either by inference or by direct indication, everything points towards first that there is a living entity, there is super soul, and there is the Supreme Lord. So one should not think that Lord does not exist. So Jiva Goswami, he comments on this verse, and his commentary shows that how this verse is giving a proof of God. So you can read that. Use some Nyaya language. Said Nanu Itaresam Tavat Katham Tasmin Bhagavati Astikya Buddhi Syat. First he raises a question. saying that you are asking us to be devoted to the Lord. But how can people have faith in the Lord to begin with? Because they don't see Him. Just now I was reading an article. The article is written by somebody who is speaking about a school somewhere. And school is supposed to teach Vedas besides the normal subjects, but propagate Vedic knowledge. And the name of the school is called Veda Ratna Vidyalaya. Vidyalaya means school, and Veda Ratna means gem of the Vedas or Vedic gem. And he says, but in the very first class they have lessons, and the book, there is a question which is asked that, do you believe in avatar, descent of the Lord? They ask this question to the students, and in India everybody will say yes, yes, we believe. So then the teacher will say that, no, you are wrong. He says, there is no avatar. And then they give a logic for this. He says, you think that Ramchandra was avatar? And everybody said yes, because in India everyone hears about Lord Ram and Ramayana. He says, how is he avatar? Because he took birth and then he died. He took birth from Kausalya and Dasharatha, like you have taken birth from your parents. And then he died. So how can he be avatar? So children, obviously, they have an answer. Then they say that God is supposed to be all-pervading. But Lord Ramachandra went to forest for 14 years. And at that time, all the people in Ayodhya felt separation from him. So if he was all-pervading, why these people felt separation? And his father even died out of separation. So why his father has to die if Lord is all pervading? So therefore, he is not God. And then they ask the question, so now do you think that Ram is God? And everybody said, no. Is there avatar? No. So this is the logic common people have against God's existence. Therefore, he raises a question here. Nanu itarasam tavat katham tasmin bhagavati astik. How can they have faith or belief that there is God? So of course this article said that there was one boy, when he heard this, he was very devoted to Lord Ram. When he heard this, he felt very bad, but he could not say anything to the teacher and he had no answer. And then he came home and he did not feel like eating. So he did not eat. And his mother asked, why you are not eating? He says, no, I'm not hungry. And in the evening father came and still he did not eat. So the mother told the father of the boy, husband, that please ask him why he is not eating. So then the boy spoke everything, that my teacher is saying that there is no avatar, and Ram is not God, and I cannot digest it.